So this year, the third grade dance is a little more intense than our usual Monet paintings. But still, thanks. Thank you, Joanne, for that laugh. One laugh. Thank you. Her child, my favorite over all of yours. It's the heat. Okay, moving on. But I did want to say this. This special in many other ways. We have five graduating seniors. We have a really heartfelt, I think you said beautiful. Well, let's give the seniors a hand. It's also special for the first time, not me, but we have, not me, a faculty performer, and it's very exciting. So you can see that right away. And don't worry about it, it's in the program. And even for me as a parent, it's a special night. I have both of my sons in the show, so it is. I mean, I'm not the only parent. But it's also representing Tobin's, a couple other families. So it's really exciting. So I just want to say, I know it's hot. Thank you for being here. If you haven't, reminder, it's a $10 suggested donation, but that's a suggestion. If the power suggestion makes you give more, all the money tonight goes to Dancers Respond to AIDS. And to tell you so a little bit more about that before we start is Sherry, who is the choreographer, artistic director, yes, also, of Shift, Dance, period, Media, period, no, but you got Sugar, the full title. She's just gonna tell you a little bit about Dancers Respond to AIDS before we begin.
Dancers Respond to AIDS. We are very happy to be here to support with a small excerpt from the piece that I choreographed, which we will be showing the entire piece on June 22nd in the Ailey City Theater Group. So we'll be giving out tickets. We'll give tickets to Barry and some flyers too for lovely students and parents. But Dancers Responding to AIDS started in 1991. It's a program that came from Broadway Cares, Equity Fights AIDS. And it supports family and AIDS organizations, over 450 around the world, nationally, internationally. And you may have heard of an organization called the Actors Fund. That is an organization that is helped by Dancers Responding to AIDS and what else? Many women's services, it goes on and on. So thank you very much for coming out, for supporting your resources, everything is appreciated. Tonight, we're going to do a piece with some singers, some very beautiful singers. And the song is Praying by Kesha, sang tonight by Megan Allen and Regina Wilson. And the dancers are coming out also. Debbie Schneider is, Deborah Schneider, is a faculty member here, and she also dances with Shift, and Alden Henderson. So they're going to do a beautiful duet. Thank you very much.
Okay, folks. Here we go. Are you ready? Okay. You don't want me to say.
Is it a country, a friend, your health, your sanity? Those things don't always last forever. They won't always be there sometimes when you need them the most. So what do you do then when you're looking for a new home in between your arms?
Thank you. So many selves, so many fiends and gods. Each greedier than every is a man. So easily one in another hides, yet man can, being all, escape from none. So huge a tumult is the simplest wish, so pitiless a massacre, a hope most innocent. So deep's the mind of flesh, and so awake what waking calls asleep. So never is most lonely man alone. His briefest breathing lives some planet's year. His longest life's a heartbeat of some sun. His least emotion robes the youngest star. How should a fool that calls him, I presume, to comprehend not numer whom?
So easily one in another hides, yet man can, being all, escape from none. So easily one in another hides, yet man can, being all, escape from none. So easily one in another hides, yet man can, being all, escape from none.
So huge a tumult is the simplest wish, and so awake what waking calls asleep. So never is most lonely man alone. How should a fool that calls him I presume to comprehend not numerable whom?
Man can escape from none. Man can escape from none.
So easily one in another hides, yet man can, being all, escape from none.
So never must lonely man alone.
Thank you.
and Ezonto are both from Ghana. Panloko is a traditional dance that tells the story of a family going to their aunt's house to have porridge. And after she has porridge, the aunt tells the story to the children of a boy who kept wanting to go to his friends, but his parents said no, so he got caught every time. Second dance, Ezonto, is inspired by everyday things. So there are some different moves in the dance that are inspired by actions that people do every day. Our third dance, the Wobble, is a social dance. It's usually done at parties and people talk to each other about doing it. It's fun to do because you can add your own dance. And the last dance is Rockin' Robin, which is a group hand game that's really fun, and people play it on the playground, and it's really great. So, yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
mature content, so if you feel uncomfortable, you can leave. I don't mean it in a mean way. I just mean if you feel uncomfortable, you feel free to take a walk.
It's not fun to be ogled at when you're walking down the street. It really makes you feel like an object or something less than human. 2 summers ago, I was at a club in Italy and I was dancing on the dance floor. And all of a sudden, this guy came up to me and touched me in a place where I didn't want to be touched. And I felt very uncomfortable. And now my idea of partying and being with random guys that I don't know kind of freaked me out.
When I was 15, I went to a New Year's Eve concert with my sister and my cousins in Europe, and it was my first like very big like music festival, and I remember it was very crowded, and there were a lot of adults. We were like, well, I passed off as 18, but I wasn't, and I just remember getting groped everywhere. I went like for the entire like 3 hours. And I didn't get to see the ball drop because I went home, because I was really uncomfortable.
So, when I was in middle school, my sister came home and she was crying and I didn't really know what it was about. And she said somebody sexually harassed her on the subway and I didn't really get what that meant. I just couldn't really relate to it. It sucked just watching her be that sad for something that I couldn't relate to.
This has been happening since I was 11 years old. I'm really fed up with it.
Thank you. Yeah, but the question is, well, how did you get there? Did you get there by confrontation, violence?
No, was that the question you were asking?
Yeah.
See, that's, I mean, that's another thing. When you talk about an evolution, most people think violence. Without realizing that the real content of any kind of revolutionary thrust lies in the principles and the goals that you're striving for, not in the way you reach them.
Thank you. Thank you.